Now, my dear students, there is an amplitude modulation problem. There are two problems related to this. First of all, the modulating signal MT is like that, that has been given, that is the AM, that is twice by FM, FM is 10 to the power 3 T, is amplitude modulated with a carrier signal CT, CT means that is AC, cos twice by FCT means FC is 10 to the power 5, find the modulation index, that is mu, that means, if you know the mu, mu is equal to AM divided by AC. What is AM? That is 10. What is AC? That is 50. So that is 10 divided by 50. Just calculate this thing. You will get, I think, 0.2 is the modulation factor or modulation, the modulating index, and the carrier power and the power required for the transmitting AM wave. That means the carrier power PC, you know it very well in the previous equation, that is AC square divided by 2R maybe, yes, AC square divided by twice R. So you know the R, you will find out this, and power required for transmitting AM wave. So power required, that is AM wave. If you know the relationship between these two, if you know the AC out of it, and you can get the another parts too. So there is another equation of amplitude wave is given like that. That is the total equation of ST. Just compare these two equation, ST AC into 1 plus AM cos twice pi FMT, and that is cos twice pi FCT. So after comparing these things, that is the FC, that is the FM, that is the AM, that is the AC. Now you have to find out the carrier power, the total sideband power, the bandwidth of FM according to the equations. Now let's carry out these things. Okay. Now AM transmitter, a low and high level transmitters. A low level AM transmitter performs the process of modulation near the beginning of the transmitter. A high level transmitter performs the modulation step last, at the last or final amplifier stage in the transmitter. That means the low level FM transmitter performs the process of modulation near the beginning of the transmitter. The high level of transmitter performs the modulation step last or final amplifier stage in the transmitter. That is the low level AM transmitter, where there's a basic block diagram. You can see here the RF carrier oscillator buffer amplifier modulation took place in the AF voltage, that is AF voltage amplifier, that means audio frequency, AF means audio frequency, and that is the RF power amplifier, and that will be antenna coupler and make throughout of the antenna. That is the low level AM transmitter block diagram. That is the low level AM transmitter where RF carrier oscillator, there are two signal paths in the transmitter, audio frequency and radio frequency. The radio frequency is created in the RF carrier oscillator. The output of the carrier oscillator is a fairly small AC voltage, perhaps 200 to 400 millivolt RMS. If the oscillator drifts off frequency, the receiver will be unable to receive the transmitted signal. Interference will occur. That means if the receiver is unable to receive the transmitted signal, the interference will occur. That is the low level AM transmitter's characteristic. And what is the buffer amplifier? The buffer amplifier is a relatively low gain amplifier that follows the oscillator. It has a constant input impedance, therefore it always draws some amount of current from the oscillator. It helps to prevent pulling of the oscillator frequency. The modulator part is like that. The modulator is a variable gain amplifier. That's the modulating signal. That is the modulated signal. That is the carrier signal in here. So it must have an RF carrier signal and an AF, that's audio frequency information signal in that portion. The modulator output is around 10 milliwatt or less. Now, what is a voltage amplifier? A microphone only produces a few millivolts of signal. This simplifies, that is a few millivolts that should have to be greater to achieve the modulation.